Good morning, dear students. In this session, we will discuss the biozoology 11th standard. The last unit and the last chapter, the unit 5 and chapter 12, trends in economic zoology. Trends in economic zoology. From the introduction to before the sericulture part. Here, what is the introduction? What is zoology? So you know already, zoology is the branch of science that deals with the study of animals. You know from previous class, what is zoology? It is a branch of science that deals with the study of animals. Study of animals. So this is called as zoology. To someone interested, career in zoology, to have some specialization in different field, different branches are there. In zoology, different branches are there. They are called a specialization. The students also interested, venture, to enter, to read, to know regarding the zoology. So in zoology, there are various zoologist. For example, physiologist. What is physiology? The physiologist who studied the metabolic process of the animals. What is physiology? Physiology means what? Study of the functioning of the organ system. What is the role of physiologist? One who study the metabolic process in animals. What is the role of taxonomist? Taxonomist. What is taxonomy? Taxonomy means naming of animals. What is the role of taxonomist who study naming and classification of animal species? Naming and classification of animal species. What is the role of embryologist? Embryologist. Embryology means what? It is a branch of the zoology. Study about the early development of, early embryonic developmental stages of the animal life. So what is the role of zoologist? Study and focus of early developmental stages of the animal life. So these are the different fields. So, as a career in zoology, career in zoology, it is a field, zoology is the main field, which is preservation and management of animal kingdom. Preservation and management of animal kingdom. So, one who zoologist, a person become a zoologist, one who watch the different channels, National Geographic, Animal, Planet and a Discovery Channel are constant need for researches and documentaries. So the zoologist can travel because nature of his job in various fields. So the zoologist are hired for zoos, wildlife sanctuaries, national park and natural organizations, conservation organizations, museum, national park, fisheries and aquaculture, museum, and pharmaceutical clinics and the veterinary hospitals. So, if you want to entrepreneur, entrepreneur means what? A business to income. So, one who is specialist for different field are called entrepreneur, businessman to income. It is an entrepreneur. So one who know about the method or learn the method of culturing farm animals. Method of culturing farm animals. Since the farm animals are greater economical value, the farm animals and their products are great economical value. During the prehistoric time, human beings taken much advantages of advantages from the animals by keeping by their under their control, keeping the animals under their control through the domestication. So in prehistoric man or traditional man always occupy the farm animals. They are domesticated. So they are used most of the work by the animals, farm animals. So it is a greater economic value for the sources of the industries, the main thing for development of farm animal and their products. So that is maintaining the development are the important sources of the zoology. So what is economic zoology? This is a general zoology. What is economic zoology? It is a branch of science that deals with the study of economically useful animals. So what is it need? It is a main aim, the economic zoology, to provide self-employment opportunities. To become an entrepreneur. So this study about the application of animals for human welfare. And also, it is not just to improve the economic condition and also very useful for food security and provide employment opportunity. It gives job to a person to increase the value of a person, to increase the economical status of a person. So based on the importance of economic farm animals or economic zoology are categorized into four. One is animals for food and products, The second one is economically beneficial animal. The third one is animals of aesthetic importance. Aesthetic means its beauty. And fourth one is animals for scientific and research. So what are the four importance of the animals? Based on the particular focus of the animals and its importance. Animals for food and food products. Animals are used for food and food products. Second one is economically beneficial animals. What are the source we need? For example, milk. It is essential source is obtained from the animals. So the milk is one of the best one for the growth. Next one is animals of the aesthetic importance, which gives beauty and the culturals. And fourth one is animals for scientific and research. So what are the animals which are obtained the scientific benefits and the research regarding their health care? Are it best importance. Okay. Now there are different fields in economic zoology. For example, vermiculture. Next one is apiculture. Another one is sericulture. Next one is lab culture, etc. So that is vermiculture means culturing of the earthworms. What is apiculture? Culturing of the or rearing of the honeybees for its economical value status. Apiculture means culturing of honeybees. And what is sericulture? Culturing of the silkworm for obtaining silk. And the next one is lab culture. So that is culturing a black insect to obtain lac. So these are the different field. First we want to know that is vermiculture. Vermiculture. Now we are talking about vermiculture. It is a vermiculture, it is the process by using of earthworms. Using of earthworms to decompose the organic matter into nutrient-rich materials capable of supplying necessary nutrients to the soil and helps to sustainable plants growth. So mainly it produces what is it? To decompose the organic matter into nutrient-rich. Decompose the organic matter into nutrient rich. Decomposing the organic matter, nutrient rich materials that supply to the soil and helps to sustainable plant life. Sustainable means continuous. The aim is to continuously increase the number of the worms to have a sustainable harvesting. Culturing and harvesting. After the culture, and again they are harvested. So what is it? The remaining worms after the using of vermiculture, either they are used to vermicompost operation or it may be sold to customers. So what is vermicompost? Vermicompost are the primary goal of vermiculture. Don't note it. It is one more question. Which one is the primary goal of vermiculture? Vermicompost. It is one of the part of vermiculture. And technically, what is vermicompost? It produces pure worm waste, which are the nutrient rich organic matter. So the earthworm releases worm waste which is made up of is rich organic matter, organic compounds. So that is nutrient rich organic compounds are there. Here the vermicompost are comprised of the casting, that is the waste from the earthworms. Another one is bits of bedding and some other activities. The application of the earthworm in technology of composting and bioremediation of the soil and other activities is called vermitech. What is vermitech? What is vermicompost? What is vermiculture? It is a first process. Another, a part of vermiculture is vermicompost. The total technology which involves composting, production of compost, which are the manure, that is a natural manure. So that is a organic manure. The production of the composting and bioremediation in the soil. What is bioremediation? So the removal of unwanted things from the soil is called bioremediation. Or cleaning the environment with pollution-free environment. Or clean the dust-free environment is called bioremediation to the soil. And other activities which are called as vermitech or vermitechnology. Vermitechnology is the technique to produce compost and bioremediation to the soil. So these first ones introduced by Sultan Ismail. Note it, Sultan Ismail in 1992. Who was first introduced the word vermitech? Sultan Ismail in 1992. Okay. Now, what is vermicomposting and the other futures? So, already I told you that. So, the animals or human life dispose solid waste. The solid waste include degradable and non-biodegradable. What is a degradable particles? The waste are broken by the microbes, easily decomposed. They are called degradable. What is non-biodegradable waste? They are accumulated in large amount on the soil. They do not break down by microbes. So they are called as not broken down by microbes. They are called as non-biodegradable waste. So it is a serious challenges in most of the countries. That is production and a dispose of the waste, solid waste. It may be deposited and it create pollution, or it is changes the nature of the soil, or it decrease the soil fertility. But the earthworm play a major role to maintaining soil fertility. So what is its role here? Earthworm which maintain the soil fertility. Hence the earthworms are called as farmer's friend. Who was the farmer's friend? Earthworms are called as farmer's friend because which increase the soil fertility. And it mixer of the humus, organic matter with the soil. Hence it is called what? Who is this? Farmer's friend. Earthworms are called as farmer's friend. And it is also called as biological indicator of soil fertility. Okay? Biological indicators of soil fertility. Biological indicators of the soil fertility. If the earthworm rich soil, it is always increase the plant growth because that type of soil containing more amount of the nutrients. So there are two questions. One is farmer's friend. Because it can produce this humus or organic matter, more amount of organic matter to the soil. And another one is biological indicators of the soil fertility. So here it is an important word. Now, why it is a biological indicators of the soil fertility? The worms that support bacteria, fungi and protozoa growth of other organisms. And it acts, the earthworm acts as a host of other organisms. It serves host of other organisms. Most of the other small animals defends the earthworm for living. So it is called as host. What is called vermicost? Vermicost. Breakdown of the organic matter. Breakdown of organic matter by the activity of earthworm and elimination from its body is called vermicost. It is a tumor. What is vermicosting? Breakdown of organic matter by the activity of earthworms and elimination from its body. That the organic matter is eliminated, is removed from its body is called as vermicost or vermicosting. Okay, vermitek, vermicompost, vermicosting. Here, this vermicost also it is improve the soil nature and also it is better to the soil because it increase the porosity of the soil. Porous means what? Holes. It provide aeration of the soil and also drainage and increase the moisture holding capacity and act as the organic manure. Vermicost act as the organic manure. Manure means what? Compost. Is easily degradable forms which are useful for the plant growth. So vermicosting means the breakdown of organic matter by the activity of earthworms and removed from its bodies called vermicosting. So these are useful. The earthworms are very useful to increase the porosity and another one is aeration. So the water holding capacity, drainage, so easily water it moves down from the soil. So another one is it acts the organic manure. Okay. So next, what are the, in earthworms, there are two major groups. Earthworms are two major groups. How many groups, how many types of the earthworms based on its nature and place they found? First group are called as humus formers. Humus formers. Tell what is it? Humus formers. Formers. Second group is called humus feeders. Second group is called humus feeders. Tell what is the first type? Humus are called decaying organic matter is called humus. Humus formers means what? Producer. These kind of earthworms, also humus formers, they always found on the soil surface, dwell on the soil surface. Always found on the soil surface. They feed on organic matter. Feed on organic matter. Generally, they are darker in color. Darker in color. These kind of worms are used for vermicomposting. Vermicomposting. Okay? What is humus formers? They are always found in the surface, soil surface. They feed on organic matter in the soil surface. They are what in color? Darker in color. Because the humus always present the upper part of the soil. It is always darker in color. What is the use of these humus formers? These worms are used for vermicomposting, to preparation of the compost, manure. What is other one is humus feeders. What's called humus feeders? They are always found in the burrowing. What is burrowing? Under the soil. The space under the soil is called burrowing. These worms are burrowing worms. Burrowing worms. So these are the humus feeders. So what is the role of this humus feeder? Directly, it increases the pores of the soil, aeration of the soil. And also distributing the humus to entire soil. What's its role? It is always found in burrowing and increase the porous of the soil. Porous of the soil. And the next one is and provide aeration to the soil. Next, distributing the humus. Distributing humus to entire soil, all layers of the soil. So those are very important. So humus formers also important. And humus feeders also very important. They are always present the soil surface. They are found in the burrowing under the soil. Under the soil. Okay. Based on the origin, there are two types of the earthworm species. The first well-known species are endemic species. Endemic species. What is the endemic species? Endemic species are called as native species. Native species. This kind of endemic species are cultured in India, in our country, in our native place or local place. So what are the endemic varieties? There are three endemic varieties. One is called Perionyx excavatus. The second one is Lambito maruti. The third group, Octoketona serrata. Tell the names. It is very difficult to read. What are the endemic species of earthworm? Or what are the native species of earthworm? It is important. One more question. What is endemic in our place? So name them Peryonyx excavatus. Peryonyx excavatus. The second one is Lambitum maruti. Lambitum maruti. The third one is Octoketona serrata. Octoketona serrata. There are three species are called endemic. What is the exotic species of earthworm? Exotic species of earthworm. What is exotic? Some earthworms are introduced in our country from other countries. They are exotic forms. Not our country, not our native places. These are introduced from other countries to India. So these are called the exotic species. The important exotic species are, the one is Acinia fetida. Acinia fetida. The second one is Eudrillus eugenii. Eudrillus eugenii. Tell the name. So Acinia fetida is what? Endemic? Either endemic or exotic? Exotic. Exotic. Both are is starting with E. We can easily identify the letter E. It is starting with E. That is exotic. Exotic. That is Acinia fetida, Eudrillus eugenii. I repeat, the name of the endemic species and exotic species of the earthworm. The endemic are the Peryonyx excavatus, Lambitum maruti, Octoketona serrata. The second one is exotic species, not culture in our countries. They are export, they are imported to our countries. Acinia fetida, another one is Eudrillus eugenii. Now, how to preparation of the vermicompost? Already I told you, vermicompost are the is an important part of the earthworm. What is a vermicompost? To break down of the organic matter by the activity of the earthworm. It's called vermicompost. So the preparation of the organic matter by the action of the earthworm associated with all other organisms in the vermicompost. In the vermicompost. How to prepare the vermicompost? Are vermicompost pits. So these normal pits, normally the place is selected, upland places, or it may be elevated level. Elevated level. This one of the pits. Just imagine, this is a small vermicomposting pit. Vermicomposting pit. Vermicomposting pit. This can be always, the place can be selected, suitable place, the upland, or it may be elevated, higher places, because it prevents the stagnation of the water. Without sanding, the holding the water, this is stagnation of the water. So the cement pit may be constructed. This is cement pit, it is made up of cement pit. So this pit is construct by using the bricks, by using the bricks. So normally this pit measurement is 3 into 2 × 1 meter. 3 × 2 × 1 meter. What is the 3 means? What? Length into depth into width. So that is 3 meter length, 2 meter depth. Another one is, what is it? Width. So that is the LBW. Okay. So what is the measurement? This is the one more question. Vermicomposting pit is measured 3 × 2 × 1 meter. 3 length. And another one is width. Is W. And the next one is depth. Depth. This is the measurement. So the size of the pit is based on the, or depends upon the availability of the raw materials. That means biomass or other things is loaded with in the pit. So this is called a measurement. So this kind of pit must be provision. It is a way for drainage of excess water to drain. So that is, it may, the provision means what? It may be small way, may be fixed to move out water, excess water, excess water. And another one is important thing for this, important things for this. It does not expose to direct sunlight. Direct sunlight. Shade may be needed. Shade may be needed. It is always shade. Because of it maintaining normal heat. Not directly covered by the sunlight. So these are, is covered by the jute bags or other things. Or other things. Next one is, what are the materials filled in the pit? Warm composting pit. The first layer is the first layer. The first layer is filled with gravel. Gravel means small stones. The first layer is filled with gravel. It hides about 5 centimeters. It is totally gravel. Small stones. The second layer is the second layer. Second layer is filled with coarse sand. This is thickness is 3.5 centimeters. This is called what? Coarse. Coarse means what? Rough. Coarse sand. This will do the coarse sand. What is it? What is the first layer? At the bottom is gravel. Above the gravel is coarse sand. The remaining space is provided for introducing the earthworm. Introducing the earthworm. So this gravel and the coarse sand is to facilitate to remove the excess water, to drainage the excess water. Because of it has several spaces, so this easily the water is goes out. So that is a drainage. Again, the earthworms are collected from the our local soil, earthworms. What is it, the earthworm collected? That is endemic species or it may be exotic species. If the local soil, the earthworm is collected, this is filled with, this bed is filled with loamy soil. That is a natural or local loamy soil at about 15 centimeter height. Above the gravel and the coarse sand. So these are filled with what soil? Suppose the local, if the earthworm is collected from the local soil, this bed is, what is the height of this bed? 15 centimeter. These are introduced the earthworm. But in the case of exotic species, no these soil layers is needed. Because they are well developed earthworms, exotic forms. So this, again, this space is filled with, this space is filled with biomass. The space is filled with biomass. Biomass means what? Decaying plant materials. Or it may be animal dung or cow dung. Cow dung is this remaining space above the coarse sand is loaded with the cow dung or biomass. So the total biomass is filled here. This cow dung has lost its heating capacity. They are filled well up to the surface level. Up to the surface level. So these are biomass. Biomass, digested biomass. So this is place. So finally, introduce the earthworms on the surface. So this layer is what? Gravel layer. This is a sand layer. These are space filled with the biomass. After filling the biomass, the earthworms are introduced on the surface. Finally, this part is covered by jute bags or cardboard, or it may be what is it, broad leaves. These are cover. So this is allow the preparation of the vermicompost. So the earthworm take several days to prepare, to produce compost, to produce compost. Then harvesting. So one can start the harvesting. Is noted for harvesting, the vermicompost is prepared. So once all the biomass are digested by earthworm, because these all biomass are taken and digested by the earthworm and release the vermicompost. It is one of the food source. This biomass or organic matter is one of the food sources that are eaten and digest and release. Nutrient-rich compound is called the vermicompost. So finally, all the compost, that is means this biomass, the total biomass, if it is digested, is produced, this vermicompost is ready. It for several days, after several days, to complete digestion of the biomass and release of the vermicompost. Release of the vermicompost. What is the next step? The vermicompost unit for next step. So immediately from the vermicompost hand picked the earthworms by creating small conical mass heaps. These are the vermicompost. These are the conical heaps. Heaps of vermicompost. So all the earthworms are hand-picked and creating a small conical heaps. Conical heaps of vermicomposting, harvested vermicomposting. So this vermicompost is placed to sunlight for few hours, not more time. This vermicompost is removed from this pit. And it forms a conical shaped heaps. It allowed to sunlight. What will be happen? Because the surface area fully occupied by earthworms. If the sunlight exposed to the heaps, immediately the earthworms moves down and settle down. All the earthworms are settled down. Because sunlight, it is a more heat, it is unable to living on the surface. Immediately it comes down on the bottom layer. These are accumulated the lower layers. So these are vermicompost is ready for marketing. The again, this kind of earthworms is removed, that is a recapture, recover and introduce in new vermicompost pit. These earthworms again used for new vermicompost pit like this. Okay? So the how to preparation of the vermicompost is important. So what is it? The vermicompost very useful is a nutrient rich materials, is organic matter, which is used for the organic manure. So this is one of the 5-mark question. How to prepare the vermicompost in stepwise manner? First, make a vermicompost pit in elevated area. It is made up of bricks. So immediately, what is the measurement? 3 meter length, 2 meter width, and the 1 meter depth. So directly, and small gravel layers, what are the things are loaded or needed for this? So only is gravels, another one is coarse sand. Next, space is filled with the biomass. Above the biomass, the earthworm was introduced. Several days to prepare and digest all biomass by the earthworms and release the vermicompost. Okay, what is vermiwash? Vermiwash. This is the important 2-mark question. Vermiwash. What is a vermiwash? This no. It is one of the liquid fertilizer. It is one of the liquid. It is collected after a passage of water through the column of vermicomposting beds. Column of the vermicomposting beds. It is a liquid. It is collected after the moving of water through the column of the vermicomposting beds. This liquid, the vermiwash, it is used as foliar, leaf, or it may be plant, snake. Because it is a liquid fertilizer used to spray the plant. So the vermiwash also nutrient-rich compounds. The vermiwash is collected by borrowing, or it may be dillosphere. The vermiwash, which contains plant-promoting nutrients, and organic compounds, and also essential microorganism or beneficial microorganism, also there. The vermiwash is made up of, these are used for the spraying, it acts as a liquid fertilizer, spraying to the plants, feeding to the plants. And also it contains plant promoting nutrient substances, plant growth substances, it acts as a plant growth substances. It increases the growth of the plants and other useful microorganisms. Okay, next one is, if the vermicompost is prepared mainly for recycling of the soil, recycling of the waste, and another one is leaf, litter, and other microorganisms that are useful for production of the vermicompost in a container is called a wormery, or it is otherwise called a worm bin. Worm bin means what? A container which contains all the compounds to preparation of the vermicompost is called wormery or worm bin. Okay, vermiwash. What is wormery or worm bin? The next one is, what are the disadvantages of earthworm? So what are the enemies to the earthworm? Because earthworms are easily attacked by several diseases, parasitic diseases. So that is particularly, what are the diseases which attack the earthworm? So these are commonly known as pest, earthworm pest. So earthworm is a smaller in size, so these are easily destroyed by or eaten by large animals. So what are the enemies? Centipede, rats, snakes, mites, a snail, birds, and other insects. That is ant. Ant also damage the earthworm. So these are the enemies. These are commonly known as pests. So these are called as external pests. What are the internal pests? Some of the worms, particularly some protozoans and some nematode worms. Nematode worms, or it may be larva of the worms also, destroy the growth of the earthworms, affect the earthworms. And larger predators also damage. Predators means what? It will destroy, which kill the earthworms. So that is, vermicomposting bits can be isolated or well protected from the other large predators. Okay, the next, so that it can be protected by the covers, a protective covers or grating at the bottom and the top of the vermicomposting bits. Okay, what are the advantages of the vermicompost? Okay students, the advantages of the vermicompost. Vermicompost is a rich essential plant nutrients. Vermicompost is a rich essential plant nutrients. And also the vermicompost improves the soil structure, texture, aeration and water holding capacity. And also it prevents the soil erosion. And the next one is vermicomposting acts as an eco-friendly system. And also it helps to farming and a terrace garden. And last, and another one is called vermicompost or earthworms, mainly used for seed germination and increase the plant growth. Okay students, so this is the class that are useful to you from the introduction to Vibhor the sericulture. Thank you for your cooperation.